Join us today and learn how to make a brochure just like this one. Hi, this is Eric from Promotion Lotion Creative Studios. We're a graphic design company. We do a lot of creative print work, and right now we're going to do a brochure for a home decor company called Cabin Feather. What you're looking at right now is Photoshop, and this is a template provided by the company that we'll be using to print these for a trifold brochure. This is the outside of the brochure, and we're going to dive right in and get started. The first thing I'm going to do is just map out some areas that I want to pay attention to. So on the left-hand side, this will be the fold-in panel. So when you open up a trifold brochure, if you look on the right side, there's a panel that's folded in. That's going to be that panel. And we're just going to set it up. We're going to set up this shape just to fit right at the guidelines for this template. And you'll see why in a little bit. This central guideline, this three here, close together, if you could see, the center one is the fold line of the brochure. So that's where the panel will end and the next panel will begin. This middle panel actually is the back outside. So if you've ever gotten a brochure in the mail where there's a mailing address on it and a return address, this is that part of it. And then this is the front cover. So what we're going to do is map out a few of the areas of interest so that I can get an idea of where I want to place the elements that I'm going to place into this brochure. Okay, so I actually created this brochure before the video because I wanted not to waste your time with me experimenting. So I have a little bit of an idea, and I have some of the files open on another screen that this screen capture software is not picking up. But you're not missing out on anything. It's just a separate screen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag in the photo that we're going to be using for the cover. And this is wrong photo, sorry. This is for a home decor company, so they provide paintings. They focus on paintings and print artwork to decorate your home. So we're going to get a picture of a living room here, and we're going to just try to crop it in so that it makes sense as a cover. You could see the stock photo we chose has a blank canvas in the background. We're gonna put something on that canvas later, but right now I just want to get this situated. So if you remember, there's a shape underneath here. What I'm going to do is, so that the photograph perfectly fits the area of the cover, I'm going to create a clipping mask. So I'm going to right click on that layer, and it's right above that shape, and I'm going to click create clipping mask. And now you can see that it's perfectly fit to the cover panel. I'm going to remove these guidelines for now, because we don't need them at this point. I just want to give you, I want to get a better idea of how this is going to look when it's printed. So let's move this around. I think I'm still going to make this a little bit smaller because there's some things that are cropped out of frame. Okay. Let me close this. All right, it's starting to look a lot better. Now, we're not reinventing the wheel with this brochure. It's going to be something pretty standard, just so that you guys can get an idea of how this works and what you can do or what we can do for you. Like I said, I created this a little bit earlier and I kind of have an idea of where we're going to go with it. So what I'm going to do is just open up some of the, drag in some of the elements that we're going to need for the rest of this. Okay, so right now we're going to drag in the icon that they use in their logo, and it's tremendous, so we're going to resize that. Now, a lot of people think the logo is one of the central features of any type of advertising or marketing collateral, but that would be a little bit wrong. People are not interested. See, I can tell you right now that's going to be too big. People are more interested in what you can do for them and not who you are. Obviously, it's important to maintain your brand across all of your different print collateral, but it's not as important as you might think. Okay, they use a font called Palmer Petit that I'm going to use just to put a tagline above here. Their tagline is "Your home with a feather in its cap," and they're called Cabin Feather. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put this tagline on a little bit of a banner, and I'm going to sample a color from the photo, which also happens to be one of their branding colors. This is another reason why we chose the photo. Now you could see that this overlaps a little bit, and we want it to be perfectly aligned with the fold. So you can create a clipping mask again, and it will clip to all of the elements that are part of the mask behind it. So I just have to drag this down a little bit because it was a little too short. I'm laying in the basic elements right now, and later I will go back and center everything and create all the proper spacing and stuff like that. But I just want to get this down, and we're going to make this text white. Now, over on the left side, I'm going to color the background and sample a color from the photo. It's a little too intense, so I'm going to decrease the opacity so that some of the white comes through and has more of a connection with the brand. The brand's lighter, more pastel look. Okay, that's good for now. Okay, I'm going to turn the guides back on. Just get a look at this. Now, I'm going to create a text frame in this left panel here. And I'm going to copy and paste some text Now, the reason there's a large space is because in the draft copy, I have a photograph here that I'm going to put in now. I'm going to create something to clip it to. Drag the photo on top of it, and again, it's a little bit bigger than it needs to be, but it's going to be clipped down onto the shape and then repositioned. Okay, maybe it could be a little wider. Gonna nudge it over, and there we go. We're gonna do a little bit of editing to that photo later on, but right now that works. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is create the mailing panel portion of this, and there's really not much to it. We're gonna basically put the logo up there and the return address and leave it kind of plain, but I'll show you how we're going to do that. So here, right here, you'll see is where the logo icon. And by the way, the front cover is not done yet, so there's going to be a little bit more there. I like to hop around and get and take stabs at the whole project rather than focusing on one area, so that it doesn't become disjointed. So I'm going to duplicate that little logo icon and drag it up. Now this would be, if it were on its side and used as a mailer, this needs to be turned clockwise 90 degrees. So we're just going to do that. And then I'm going to decrease the size a little bit because it's a little too big. That's nice. Now we're going to put in the font, and then you're going to rotate that 90 degrees clockwise. Going to change the font. Got a lot of fonts. It doesn't have to be big at all. I'm going to just line it up by eye for now. Okay, good. Now, let's go back to the cover. There's a couple of things I want to do here. I've actually already done them, so I kind of know that they're going to work. But I'm going to pretend like this is a brand new idea. Ooh, that canvas really needs something. What could we put there? I know. Cabin feather, let's put something like a nice feather on it. How about that? Boom. That's a big feather. So we're gonna decrease the size till it fits on the canvas. Oh, okay. Now, I say now a lot, I guess. Now you can see that the canvas is not exactly white, but the background of the photograph is. So there's a million different ways in Photoshop to get rid of that. But the easiest right now, and the one that'll work the best for this, will be to change the layer effect, and that the blending effect, to darken. And there you go. That looks like a nice piece of artwork. Corresponds with the brand. And boom, there you go. So the only thing for the... There's a couple more things for the cover. I don't like the solid white bottom part. And when I was working on the inside of the brochure, which we'll get to later, I discovered an idea that I think is going to work here too. Because this is artwork, and it's mostly what they sell, on the inside, they had requested that we, you know, we just put some samples of the artwork, more like a catalog rather than an informational brochure. So what I did was, because some of the artwork prints have white borders around them, and I'll show you later, you couldn't discern the border from the background, and I didn't want to use a lot of color on the inside. I wanted the artwork to speak for itself. So I got the idea of using a textured photograph of a wall. It's just a close up of a wall. And I found a nice one on my stock website, and I think I'm going to use that to fill in the white space on the front cover. So I'm going to drag that in. Now, let me just move it around so you can see what it is. It's just a close-up of a stucco-ish. No, not stucco, like a spackled wall. I don't know what the proper term would be, but you get the picture. So what I'm going to do is drag that behind all the layers. And I actually don't want to use it for the mailing panel cover, because I want to create some separation, and there's a lot of non-distinct rules that the Postal Service has about what kind of things can be in the mailing area, and I always try to put as little as possible so that there's not any problems. If you have the snap turned on, you can drag the photo and it'll snap to the edge where that clipping mask is. And that shouldn't be a problem. Now the only things left to do here, I want to put the URL there. I'm going to type in their name. And I'm going to put actually some artwork on this wall here. Some of the artwork that they offer, because this looks kind of plain and unbalanced in the way the couch is. It's heavy on the right side, so I think I'm put a piece of artwork here and maybe one behind the couch, and we should be good to go for the outside of the brochure. So let's get to work on that. There are a million ways to do stuff in all of these programs. I've been doing this for over 15 years, and this is the way that I still do it. It works for me, and it works for my customers, so I'm happy with it. I'm sure some of you younger kids will have some shortcuts that I don't use, but this pays the bills for me. Ooh, wrong font. Parma Petite. make some adjustments to the icon. There we go. And we're going to put the URL. And we're going to use the Lato font, because that works well with their brand. Change it to about 12. At the end of this project, I'm going to go back and I'm going to check on all the branding colors, and I'm going to more closely match everything. But it works best for me to get my ideas down and to get some work done so that we can move forward without procrastinating. Because if you get caught up in all the nitty-gritty details, the project could be a real drag, and you want it to be fun, you want it to flow, otherwise life is hard. Now the last step for the outside of the brochure is to add the artwork to that little photo, and I had done that already, but I accidentally closed the file, and now I'm going to just redo it at a smaller scale, so bear with me for one sec. Okay, so now I'm going to drag in one of their pieces that they sell, and the file is huge, so I'm just going to decrease the size real quick, maybe 10%, still way too big. This is a horizontal piece and looks like it should go behind the couch. It's still a little too big. That looks pretty good. Now, what's going to happen is when you put in a photo like that, it doesn't naturally look like that, like the area around it, because it's not getting any of the reflected light from the scene that it's in, because it's artificially there. So you know, there's some tricks you can pull to make it seem like it fits and that it's really there. One of them is always putting a shadow behind it so that it looks like it's on the wall. Most people often overdo the shadow though, so just make it subtle and light. It's barely there. And the second thing you can do, create a layer on top of it, sample a color that's on the wall. The light looks like in this photo it's coming from the front. So let's take a little bit of the reflected light off the wall that's bouncing off the room. Coming from the side, you see the lighter side of that shade? Means the light's coming in this way, and this is the shadow area. So the left side of this painting should be a little brighter than the right. So we're going to take the darker sampled color from the wall. We're going to paint on top of the painting a little bit. Blur it out. Create a clipping mask. Decrease the opacity. And again, these things are all very subtle. If you overdo them, they won't work and it just looks artificial. Let's play with the blend mode, see what works best. Now it doesn't look like much, but if you take it away, You could see the subtle difference. Let me darken it a little bit. See the difference? Looks more natural. Looks like it's supposed to be, like it's really there. Now there's one more painting that needs to go in here. And I chose this work because it kind of matches the colors of the brand and the brochure that's working. This is tremendous as well. This is one of their original print files. And they're huge. So let's just bring that down. And we're going to do the same thing with this one. It's a little big. Take it down some. Gives a little more balance to this photo. And contextually, it means something now. I'm going to copy the shadow style from this one and paste it onto. Oh, you know what? The shadow is in the wrong direction on the first. Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, it is. Since the light is coming from the left, you want the shadow to extend out to the right. So you just change this little slider thing here. And then copy that. You can copy the style by right-clicking on it. And then you can create the same. You can paste that style onto the other one. Now, I have a feeling that if this were really in the room, the intensity on the left side of it would wash out the painting a little bit. So I'm going to do the same thing I did with the other one, but instead of darkening it, I'm going to lighten it on the left side. And I'm not going to go quite white, but I'm going to go closer to white. I'm going to paint over the left side. Create a clipping mask. Blur it out. And decrease the opacity. Maybe a little more. And now it actually looks like it's in the room. Being affected by the things that are in the room. And the light that's hitting the room. One problem is that I think it still looks a little too big. So let's go in and just take care of that. It's going to bug me. That's better. That's much better. Is that shadow? And so far, we've got the outside of the brochure pretty much done. I'm sure we're going to come back and do some more work to it. But take a look at that. That's a nice looking brochure. I wouldn't mind that, having that as my brochure. Going to take one final look at the outside of the brochure for now. Make sure there's nothing major that I'm going to forget about later on that I want to correct. So the only thing that's coming that I'm noticing is that on the little tagline on the cover, I should not have capitalized home. So I'm going to fix that right now so I don't forget about that. And I think we're good to go. We're going to head over towards the inside for a little bit. And this is going to be pretty much an example catalog of some of the stuff that they offer. So let's get rid of these for a minute. And there's three types, basic main types of prints that they offer is poster prints, framed poster prints, and then the original painting itself. So I'm going to separate the three panels into those categories. And what I want to do is, I'm going to sample this color over here. And I'm just going to make some headings to define each panel. Turn those guides back on so I can center this. Just duplicate it and slide it over, holding shift so that it stays straight. We might do a little something to define each of those panels differently later, but right now it looks okay to me. What we're going to have to start doing is bringing in some of the artwork that they have, and what we're going to do is we're going to try to make them all the same height so that this has a nice clean symmetrical look to it. And I will probably speed up the video for most of this because it's kind of tedious and you don't need that. You don't need that in your life. Okay, I brought in all of the artwork. I had it ready to go in another file because I knew this would take a long time and it's not really of any value to you. So what I'm going to do is now I'm just going to align them and show you some tricks on how to do some spacing that I learned over the years. So in this first column, the first panel, we have the poster prints. Oh, that reminds me, I'm going to bring in that background that I was talking about, because the poster prints, you can't see it now, but they have a 1-inch border around them and it's indistinguishable from the background. So what I'm going to do is bring in that wall photo that we talked about earlier and you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. Okay, there's the image. We're gonna put it on the in the background here. It's a very large image, so I'm gonna reduce the size. That looks good. Okay, now you could see it around the works in this column, this panel. There's the white border that these posters are, they're posters, so they're supposed to look like that, and we want to convey that. So we're also going to add a drop shout out to them anyway, but it just helps to make a nice distinction. So we're going to go over to the first one, and we're going to play with the shadow options. Again, never go overboard with the shadows. It looks kind of hokey if you do. The default settings are always a little too strong. I like the way that one looks. Now you could just copy the layer style, shift and hold on all the images, and paste the same layer style on all of them. And it'll give you that same shadow on all of the imagery. So what I'm going to do now is align these, left align them. Okay. I probably should have fast forward through this part of the video too, or sped it up, but I'm lonely, so you're gonna hang out with me for a little bit. Oop. What I'm doing is I'm selecting multiple layers at a time, the ones that these images reside on, and then I'm clicking up here to the left align icon. So now we have them all left aligned properly. The next thing I want to do is space them equally, or in a pleasing manner. So I'm going to group them now into their respective panels. So you select them and drag them down to this icon right here, which is the group, creates a new group. Shift, click, pull. Okay. Now I'm going to select all the groups and I'm going to align the top of them. So now they're all aligned to the top. Move them down a bit. And now this, I want to adjust the spacing between the two columns in each panel. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a rectangle. And I'm going to extend it from the bleed line, from the trim line on the left side of the brochure, to the line that indicates the panel fold. And I'm going to do hit free transform, and right here 573.7 is the exact middle of this panel. So I'm going to create a new guide. I have to deselect. I'm going to create a new guide, vertical, 573.7. So you want each, well, some of these are not the same proportions, but You want the center line of the division space to be right here. So what I'm going to do now is adjust this to, I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. And now, this one's a little smaller than these two. So these two will butt up against this guideline that I'm going to drag in right now. Then I'm going to select those images. There are a million ways to do this. It's the only way I can think of right now. Oops. Now I'm going to hold down shift, pull it away. Oop. That wasn't supposed to happen. Now I'm going to just use my key, my left arrow key, to move them over. And you'll see that this image, the biggest one, is up against that divider. And now these left aligned ones, the left side, will all be against the divider. They already are, so I don't have to move them. And now let's see how that looks. Okay, good. Spacing them out a little bit, it lets the artwork breathe a little bit, and you can get a sense of the individual piece rather than seeing them all meshed together. Looks better. And now we'll do the same thing in the center panel. Going to rotate this again. From the fold line to the fold line, should be almost exactly the same, except it's a tiny bit different because you have to account for the width of the paper in the fold, so there's a slight variation. But thank the print company for calculating that for you, because they provided in the template. Now, the exact center is 1688.7, so I'm going to put a new guide in there. Going to rotate this one because it has the same width as this column. And now let's select those and move them around. Just use the arrow key. There you go. And now the second set. This isn't as riveting as the first half of the presentation, but it's necessary. And on to the third column. And we will space them equally as rows as well, using the same process. how this last row all these images are the same height and they were already aligned. At their bottoms, so before I brought them in, this is a task that would have been done, could have been done much easier in something like InDesign or Illustrator, but the rest of the project I'd prefer to do in Photoshop, so I chose Photoshop to do this. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I like the spacing there, so I'm going to use that as a guide to move this row up a little bit. So I'm just going to drag this down, align it to the bottom here. Oh, it's almost perfect. I did it by eye. How about that? 15 years, I'm good for something. Now, the people I'm doing this brochure for, they want the title of the work and the SKU number. So I'm going to use the Lotto font again. I'm going to put in the title and the SKUs under each. I'm going to left align them. And I will speed up this part as well. Enjoy the hypnotic flow. One little trick I want to mention and then I'll speed it up again is I did the first one, duplicated it, I dragged them over to where I wanted them to lie underneath the artwork. I didn't change any of the text yet. Now I'm going to select them all, group them, duplicate the group, and just drag it down. Fine-tune it with the arrow keys just so that the spacing is consistent and I don't have to go crazy. Now I'll go in and type all the specifics for each one of these, so sit back and zone out. Okay, so I'm going to make some final adjustments. Add a little bit of contact info at the bottom, and we'll be good to go. I'm going to turn the guides back on. I'm going to drag in. Oops. That's supposed to go there. This goes here. Change it to the name. Turn the guides off, see how it looks. Looking good to me. Now, of course, I will go back and double check everything, proofread, check the color combinations, all the finer details, but this is basically how it's done. And there are a million ways to do it. This is my way. This is the way we do it at Promotion Lotion most of the time. If you're interested in seeing some more of our work, you can go to the website, www.promotionlotion.com, and check out some of our portfolio, some of the services we offer. We offer all sorts of printing, print design, branding, logos, whatever you need to get your business out there and looking good. One thing I want to do before I end the video is I'm going to upload this to my printer, and they have a function that shows you how it's going to look when it's folded and unfolded. So, yeah, let's take a look at it. Okay, so here we are at my the printer that I use, and they offer a function that's very helpful. You can visualize the folds of the brochure, make sure you got it right, see how it's going to look. Those are the both sides, and now you can see how it's going to fold. There you go. See? And then you can open it. Beautiful. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe, leave comments, make fun of my New York accent, whatever. Take care.